company and state-owned ICT service provider company. And here we are running a LibreOffice migration for the Hungarian industries, like all of them except the defense. So actually, about this project, my next talk will be about the technical side. This is the human side, so the one that is covered by the migration. Little motto, just like that. So this is the learning process for all of us. Our ministry contact person says this all the time, and he means that in such a large scale pioneering migration, we cannot prepare for everything. So we must continue learning all the time. Unfortunately, the migration protocol helped us to prepare for the first. So let's see how we implement those ideas in the actual situation. So all of that started with this government decision. Main goal is to reduce the ratio of using Microsoft's licenses in the ministries, not entire migration, so the goal is year by year more and more users, but the ultimate goal is like 60%. So it talks about those for office licenses, but virtually the office was the only viable computer in this area. So highlights of action items that this decision. So first of all, it required cooperation from multiple institutions like for the educational materials, National Public Service University was tasked to create educational materials. Also, it called for creating a support team inside this. That's my team. Also, it was required to assess first user needs, and only those users who can do their job with LibreOffice to be migrated. Okay, so educational materials needed to be created, and also one very important item of our project is the central office template repository, which is supposed to be interoperable between Microsoft Office and LibreOffice, and so that only one set of templates need to be created. And because of these templates are supposed to create interoperable, so interoperability problems, at least in the most common documents, should stop appearing. So, yeah. So this project, because of its gradual nature, creates opportunity for migrating the lower levels of public administration, whatever else, because users in the ministries have very different needs. So if you can find a solution for their needs with LibreOffice, then everyone else is supposed to be happy with LibreOffice. project had multiple phases. When it first was preparing this development decision, I was involved in that as well, COVID. That was in 2016. Actual implementation started in 2017, which was like about planning the project in general and the software interoperability needs and what users actually need from us. So during the middle of 2017, we assessed the user needs. That was about 4 or 5 months. And the results I will show in the next talk. That's more like also, we asked for documents to prove that they are actually using those features that we need potentially listed. But also, we learned a lot from those documents apart from that. Okay, after assessing, selecting users to migrate started end of 2017. And it happened gradually, like one ministry at a time. And it's still ongoing. So it's a little bit slow, but not more steady.
Sorry for interrupting, just can you please speak up?
Okay. So while supporting users, next phase, which is right now, while continuing to supporting the migrated users, happened in the first half of 2018, we started developments on LibreOffice as well. I will talk about that in the next talk. So, in the beginning, we pulled the ideas from the migration protocol and it helped people to prepare for what to expect. And so, it was not a surprise that the greatest problem is the psychological barrier of fear of change itself. Not only in the companies, but in general, changes. Very unwanted in this rather conservative environment of the ministries. So they are busy people, they want to do their jobs, please do your assignments. That's their approach. So we met more negative feelings. More negative feelings. So people felt that this is forced out of them by upper level decision makers. And during the selection of users to be migrated, we intentionally omitted the higher level decision makers. Just as a precaution. So this is somewhat founded. Also, the ones that are selected for migration, they feel themselves to be punished because someone is taken from them, and someone is experimenting on them. But the first thing is that they feel that they don't know this software, but they don't know if they will be able to do their job, their daily job, with this. And so, because they are afraid that they cannot do their job, they are resisting. So, okay, so this is what we have to solve. So people feel that something is taken from them. So we need to solve this by trying So communication activities, we just common sense establish baseline communication activities. Most important of these is that we focus on the solutions, we focus on the bright future, and try to do infotainment like posts on the website. Also, user feedback is very important. When we get a question from one user, we write a support article on the website based on that question, based on that answer. Because if that was a problem for one user, let's put it up for all of them. Who knows? Maybe someone else can be can use it as well. So more things to be communicated. The main motive behind this decision was better independence. So not cost saving, we don't care about cost saving, like 90% discounts, 5% saving, you still can go to hell with that. So vendor independence is most important. Well, actual users cannot really understand or feel the benefits of that. So we communicate more things as well, right? LibreOffice is customizable to the expectations of users, to the public administration. What do we do for that? Is like provide default setting package and default style settings, so that we replace the community made empty document template in Writer and replace it with a custom one, which contains styles that are created to mirror the requirements of our typical industry users. So how do they create typical documents? We have styles for those needs. Also, we have we can say to users that they can install at home as well. Using free software is sustainable in the long run, and it has of course excellent language support, which is very important for Hungarian public administration. Like translate user interface and scratch ID. And we also have quite a few additional layers. So what channels do we use for this? We send emails about updates, which I have many half here also. We should send actually more emails because users are reading their email but not on the website anymore. So we need to remind them that there is this support resource for them. Also we started to do lately on-site presentations for the people to be migrated because we need to assure them that they are not being punished, they will be able to do their job with the new software, and we encourage them to come to the trainings because it's not actually trivial to make them come. So we are a service provider, we can offer them training, but we cannot force them to actually come and actually sit down for 2 days, get out of work because they have a lot of work on their own. So it's actually a little bit challenging to actually make sure people are getting the training and not complaining that, oh, I cannot use this software, I went back for one. Did you come to the training? No, I didn't. because we invited the leaders, and we tell them it's okay, we are here. Also, we have as general communication documents that are downloadable, printable, and very dense with information about how to use so they can implement their best, which is downloadable from our homepage, like the FAQ documents which we created. So homepage, it's for the software and the tool. It's not available to the outside world, but for only for the government internal network. So ministries and other centrally institutions can see this general information about. So we have general information about the project, about the templates repository, how to use the templates, description of how to get help from us, and how to get a plan or training. We update this twice a week with tutorial articles about features and tips and tricks and so on and so on. This is one more screenshot of that page. One extra post. It's very short, with a screenshot, and very, very much on to the point, so not too much information. It's like you can understand this particular feature in 2 minutes. So training. So training materials. We have e-learning videos based on most important features that we have seen in video form. And that was made by the university, and currently is under reworking. It will be much better than it was before. So users are not able to take this course because there is a mandatory training system by this university, and they actually get points for doing this training. Also, we have in-person trainings. which is one day of writer and one day of call. And it can be on beginner and on advanced level. Also, we have some of the impress training. So, users, importance. Of course, we are a big company, so it's multiple levels. Like, first level is the general user support. They can answer the simplest question. Second level is remote expert support. They can log into the computer of the user to show them how to do something that the user cannot do. And third level is like, so if we saw very bad damage by the document, you can repair that or give more serious advice to the user that the second level is not clear for staying the first two levels. And also if we arrest, we can visit the user in person. Okay, template repository, a little bit of that. So ministries are using standard templates. It's standardized by their own document management tools. So it's like 15 of the most common things that they do. What we recommend is that they create .exe files, so .xml, which is to be used later on, both in Microsoft Office and LibreOffice. Also, we configure both Office suites to use this template repository. Formerly, they had the template stored on their internet pages, so they have to download it and then write from the internet browser and save it on their desktop. And basically, this was just a very inefficient workflow. But by integrating this into the Office suite, we can make it a little bit more straightforward and efficient. Also, because we have only .exe templates, it's easier to maintain them for the ministry contacts. Because not anyone can upload such templates, only a selected few per ministry, and we train those people in creating efficient document templates. Okay, a little bit more. It changes creating databases. Some cases we met with users that manage enormous amounts of data in spreadsheet applications, which was completely inefficient, especially when it was used by using LibreOffice, which is a little bit slower, more memory hungry than Excel, so it was not a great choice. But the idea is that these cellular databases can be managed locally as a SQL database, either in Excel format.
10 minutes.
Either in Excel format or in base format. It's a little bit experimental still, but we are to work on this as extra service. Okay. So internal developers, we started to have since this July internal developer team. It's currently one senior developer, a bit less than that, and we And so any movement that is made also can be communicated so that users are assured that this software is actually developed for that, so that feedback is taken into consideration, because if they report something that is broken, we can fix it. Not always, but sometimes we can actually fix their problems. And so interoperability is being improved by our team. I will talk about this later in the next talk. So finally, summary. I think that with these measures, based on the migration protocol, we can overcome resistance to change. And actually, we can make users feel that they are actually getting more support than they did previously. And one more thing is that users should, after this, feel that they are not that alone, like previously they were. There is a support team, there is a support that we can actually provide, and whenever they approach us with some problems, we can solve them. And this results in happy users, at least that's our hope. So thanks for your attention. Stay for my next talk. Yes, Paul.
Thanks for your presentation, Gabo. Really good work. And a short question. The choice to have the template in docx, docxm, is that did it give a lot of discussion? Because I understand the technical part. Even did it myself once for a customer, but I have quite some discussion because you keep yourself bound to be shipping quite soft formats, which is.
I will talk about this in the next talk.
Thanks! Keep it for then. Okay.
More question. Yes, more.
First, I think that this is something really huge, and you are being really modest. Because I just checked, sorry for not knowing, but I just checked what Mr. Z.
Yes,
I don't know how you pronounce it.
Almost like this.
I don't. I just checked what this is. It's a huge service provider.
Yeah, it's like 1,500 people or so.
Yeah, I mean, it's huge. And what I didn't understand is the plan of migration for the all, as it's written here, 275 institutions, or some of them, or within some period.
So the government decision set milestones. It's like 20%, 30%, 45, 60. But that's just milestones. So that we know what is the goal and how much work is to be done. But actually they won't shoot the project because we don't reach the 20% by the deadline. Everyone knows that deadlines are just there for you to know that what is expected of you, but not really enforced. So this is a answer to this.
Okay, just another question is when you're mentioning the developers, okay, we are here, know who they are, but I'm not asking for them, I'm asking about the organization. Are they now, do they work for NIST or they are actual external contractors?
No contractors, internal workers. Okay. Just like normal employees, like anyone else. Because the decision was made in the ministry that we are to be hire people and solve problems that way with internal competence. So we are building current internal competence. And it looks like it's so far enough.
Okay, and I'm similar to to this, Diana, I have a question about Persian. It's not only for them, it was a matter of choice, interesting choice, 6-0 something, okay? But in your case, there is additional question to that question version, is because current patches that I saw are for 6-2, 6-1, so either you will have to wait until there is a release version, or you can make a specific, your own build with the backport and those fixes back again. What do you do?
We do everything, so basically we use the community version of LibreOffice, but not the 0.0,